Hello and welcome to Pixel This 31. Can you believe it? Woo! We're googly eyes for all you people out there in Pixel Vision land. Here's one of the first posters for Pixel This some like 31 years ago. Can you believe that we've lasted 31 years and here we're going more disco ball eyeballing for lo-fi hijinks. These pixel cameras were invented by James Wickstead from 87 to 89. These little suckers were on the shelves in toy stores. James Wickstead's interview by us has recently been posted on YouTube, so check it out. Pixel This, yeah, right, Bruno knows, yeah. Pixel This is generously supported by no one. There's no money involved in our film festival, thank God. So keep your money to yourself and get creative, because there were 400,000 of these suckers made and they're still available. BenInstruments.com fixes them. You can find them. Find a Pixel camera and make a film and enter our festival. Cinema is 130 years old, approximately. The Ann Arbor Film Festival, where we were spawned, is 60 years old. Here we are, 31 years old. You do the math. That's amazing calculations going on there. The Akashic Records of Cosmic Awareness. This year we want to especially thank Bruno. Bruno, thank you.
Hey, that's me.
Bruno knows all the buttons to push and helps us immensely, besides being a really funny guy. So welcome to Pixel This 31.
Pixel's so blurry, I don't even need to shave. You can't tell. I've got whiskers.
About 100?
At least 500 whiskers.
Ooh, 500. Wow.
Can't tell. Oh, hello.
Oh, hello there. How you doing?
Me?
Yeah. Still black and white?
Still black and white.
Mm-hmm.
How about you?
Me?
Are
no.
you still black and
white?
Oh,
no.
You're not.
I'm in color.
Ooh, color.
Yeah, now I'm live.
Alive, are you?
Live in black and white.
Well, what makes you think I'm not alive?
Because you're flat.
Flat, yeah.
And
flat,
you're black yeah. and white. Black and white.
Black and white, yeah.
And do you breathe air?
No.
Nope. You don't?
No, I don't need oxygen. I just, I just seem to, like, just keep going. I mean, you could come back a year later and I'll still be here.
No, I can't come back in a year and celebrate the 31st anniversary of Pixel.
Can't. Oh, really?
Yeah, it's a big year.
Well, that's quite the occasion.
31st anniversary.
Really? Wow,
yep.
30.
Yeah. No, 31st.
By the way, did you know that the Ann Arbor Festival is 60 years old?
Ooh,
60 years old.
60. Wow.
What is that? Carry the 3.
Drop the 2.
Multiply. Start.
Divide in half.
Did I ever tell you what Albert Einstein's greatest formula says?
E. Albert Einstein?
He wrote, Albert Einstein wrote, E equals F flat. Same note.
F flat, that's good. Oh, that's good. That's good.
Yeah. Listen. Ann Arbor's 60 years old, so that makes it like 19, I would say 61.
Yeah, 61,
no.
I'd say.
56.
No, 61.
60?
61.
Ann Arbor is 60. 30.
No, that's Pixel's 30.
What are you talking about?
Michigan is old.
60.
60. From 1961.
Film, evidently, according to Jerry, is 130 years old for film. So 130 years ago was 1891.
Yeah, but that's Jerry.
So 1891. No, is that right? Yeah, 1891. Yeah.
Carry the 100 with
with Jerry.
You can't tell because, you know, is he talking about the international invention or American?
With Jerry, you don't know if he's talking French invention of film or American invention of film. Because, you know, I consider myself an internationalist.
Yeah, and Americans think they did everything. Pyramids, bridges.
Exactly.
They didn't.
You know, Americans can do things right, but not everything right was done by Americans.
Exactly.
And you can put that in your hat and smoke it. No,
no,
I'll eat my hat. Or you smoke your hat and I'll eat my hat.
I'll have the salad.
Did you know that the digital presentation of this year's Pixel Fest 30th anniversary
31.
That's what I 31. Said, 31. The voice of God.
The voice of God. Wow.
31 is, that means it's 1990.
Yeah, 1990.
And Michigan. 60 years for Ann Arbor.
Yes.
Is that correct, voice of God?
Film?
Yes. 60 years. And Ann Arbor, the reason I bring up Ann Arbor, 60-year film
festival
demonstrating, exhibiting films, it's because that is the birthplace of the Pixel Fest. It's kind of an offshoot of the Ann Arbor, Michigan festival.
Michigan! And how old is film?
1891. Okay, let's sing about our favorite subject, COVID.
Get a shot.
COVID-19.
Get a shot. Long, sir.
Hey, good to see you again.
You too.
Listen,
looking good.
Maybe we should get together on the 32nd anniversary of the Pixel Festival, or maybe we should go to Ann Arbor.
Michigan?
Yeah, you and me go to Ann Arbor.
Wow. Yeah.
Good to see you again.
Good
to keep on staying healthy.
Stay flat.
Your love is like a roller coaster, baby. Love COVID-19.
I don't love it.
You love COVID-19 like me.
I do not.
I don't love 19.
I know.
We should have COVID-21.
20 and a half.
COVID-22.
22 and a half.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
That'll do.
Repeat after me. I am happy. I am happy.
I am happy.
Happy, happy, happy. Happy, happy, happy.
Thank you. broadcast by Val Paulson. Hello, this is Charizard from Stuffy News. Lately, there has been a Stuffy outbreak. The Stuffy is purple, tall, and human-like. If you see him, call 911. His name currently is Mewtwo. He is a psychic type, and he is kind of really mean.
Hello, this is Sizzle P with an urgent report. There has been an outbreak of Stuffy virus. If you see anyone with it, please wear a mask. Some signs are fabric, plush, and weird walking. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Articuno. Today I will teach you how to be psychic. At the end of this news report, I would like to thank Charizard, Articuno, and Sizzle Pede. Thank you.
bubbling along, singing your song, or your hat's in your hand, or you're putting on airs. Your bubble may pop when the music says stop. You're in a strange world of musical chairs. Musical chairs, musical chairs. He started the game with all that he cares. Now no stimulus check while the neighbors got theirs. He's stuck in the game of musical chairs. Round and round the days we go, in a mansion with canes and easel, or in a room broke with four kids in tow. Pop goes the weasel. Bougainvillea and booze, shake it, don't stir. Shelter in place was easy for her. She landed in one of her luxury lairs. She's winning the game of musical chairs. In a hazmat gown and gloves, people are dying. He's all out of friends. How long will this last? When will it be past? He's sick of this game of musical chairs. But watch out when you've got more than flu. And that chair is pulled out from under you. You're the loser in the game of musical chairs.
Here are the cats of East Falls, Philadelphia, and I see them on my walks through the neighborhood. And I wanted to introduce you to my friend. This is a little cat we like to call Ainsley, because she lives on Ainsley Street. This cat is so darn cute. You have to stop moving your feet to pat her while she rolls around on the ground, getting dirt all stuck up in her fur. And she's so cute, that's why we love her. This cat's named Ainsley to us, probably not to anyone else. Here's a cat named Sunshine. He has the biggest attitude of anyone. When I see him on a walk, I know I have to be careful about how I pet him. Claus. This cat is the boss. He's one of the first cats we met in the neighborhood. We didn't know his name until someone told us, man, that cat's the boss. We still don't know his actual name, but we've seen him once or twice with a person who we think is his owner, who has hair that's as orange as his fur. But at least he's the boss, the cat who we still see around. Ginger is a sweet cat and we love to see her, but we never quite know where she's gonna be, cause she's always on a different porch on that street. And sometimes people don't like us stopping and paying lots of attention to her in front of their house. If you come and take a walk in East Falls, you might meet some of these cats. Except for this one, Coco, because she's our cat and she stays inside. She's 19 years old. Thanks for watching.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name is CT. I love you.
I love you too, CT. Can you say, I am happy?
I'm happy, blah, blah, blah.
Now I'm going to put the hats on you. Okay, Maya, how many hats should we put on you? One, two.
All the hats.
Three. Four. Five.
Six. Seven.
Eight, nine.
Ten.
Ten. How many hats do you have, Maya?
Ten. Now you try.
More hats? I cannot believe all these hats.
Way, oh, day, oh, way, oh, May. Hello. That's Mage in the middle. Oh. So, so, mo, no, no, pro, so, pro. With the flat and the hat, flat and the back.
Hello? Hello? Oh, there we are. Shit. pity. Up and mess up the scene. I like to stand in the crowd and watch the people wonder, damn. But think about it, then you understand. I'm just an addict, addicted to music. Maybe it's a habit, I gotta use it. Even if it's jazz or the quiet storm, my own could beat up, converted into hip-hop form. Like a rhyme and comedian, every show you see me in. Deep concentration, cause I'm no comedian. Jokers are wild, if you won't be tame. I treat you like a child and you're gonna be named. Another enemy, not even a friend of me. Cause you'll get fried in the end when you pretend to be. Pause and I can breathe it. You compare my mind with yours. I wake you up and as I stare in your face, you seem stern. Remember me? The one you got your idea from. But soon you start to suffer. The tune gets rougher when you start to stutter. That's when you had a muffler. Fighting it a moat. You choke. You can't provoke. You can't cope. You should have broke because I ain't no joke.
Your last name again?
Galliano.
Galliano!
Thank you. So good to be here, Jerry. So, I was at the supermarket recently, and I saw they were selling birthday candles. Buy one box, get five for free. And, you know, that's what I call a blowout sale. I think Abraham Lincoln should have been an actor instead of the president because he had a great headshot. Diamonds are just like herpes. They last forever. And I gave them to my girlfriend for her birthday. Does masturbating at work count as working hard or hardly working? I think gateway drugs are almost as bad as gateway computers. So my full name is Bruno Cedric Herman Cofield Galliano, and yes, I named myself. So the mayor in my town won because he promised to build new playgrounds for the kids. And, you know, that's what I call a swing vote. So I had sex with a model once, a model truck. I'm getting older now, I'm getting older. My pube line is receding, so I'm really starting to age. Thank you very much. Good night.
Thank you. Thank you. You can't teach an old dog new tricks. Good, Dad.
Thank you.
My friend just found this book in the garbage, and I'm gonna look up how much it is. My phone. Oh, 1920, that's a long time ago. That was like 100 years. Oh, it's $5. I wonder if we could read that on this phone. In 100 years.
Thank you. This is darkest. This is darkest before the dawn. This is darkest, mama. This is darkest before the dawn. But if you step off that ledge, my friend, the sun won't rise before you're gone. They say mind that fall, son, 'cause it's a long ways down. Oh, they say mind that fall, son, 'cause it's a long ways down. If the ground rise up to meet you, oh, there's no turning back around. The days grow shorter. Oh, man, winter's coming down this way. Oh, the days grow shorter, mama. Oh, man, winter's coming down this way. But for the man that's broken, the sun already went away.
Game Blame by Penny Safranik. So I cried in my sugar spun dessert after rice and raisins and a white terry cloth robe in the luxury of Armand. Hey, cry on with stars and stripes in your eyes. Have you seen the gloom where we brought the gloom? Doom. Then who's to blame? Own up, they said at the sugar factory in Egypt. That guns are sent by us. We are to blame of U.S. descent. Own up, own up. Who sent the guns? Who told them to run? Have fun, a place of your own. Displacing others not known, but they've come to haunt you. Killed by guns. Who's to blame? What a shame. Who sold them guns to kill our sons? Who's to blame? What a shame. At the sugar factory in Armand, Egypt, they made me feel so bad and sad. Who sold them guns to kill our sons? Who sent them guns to kill our sons and then to run? Own up, displacing others not yet known, but here they come to haunt you. Who's to blame? What a shame. Own up. They said at the sugar factory in Armand, Egypt, that guns are sent by U.S. We are to blame of U.S. descent. Own up, who sent them guns? Who told them to run? Have fun, a place of your own, displacing others not known. But they've come to haunt us, killed by our guns. Who is to blame? What a shame. So I cried in my sugar-spun dessert after rice and raisins, with the white terry cloth robe, the luxury of Armand. Out, out, who's to blame? What a shame. Have you seen the gloom where we brought the doom? Sound of harmony comes from the city today. Through the fires are burning away. Who sold them guns to kill our sons? Who's to blame? What a shame.
Mirror, mirror, on the wall, who's the greatest pixel star of them all? It's you, Joey Icon. It's you. It's you, Joey Icon. It's you. Yes, you can. If you can dream it, you can be it. On and on and on. Joey, Joey, Joey Icon.
No room. The clock ticked its last talk, leaving broken glass on the stairs. Empty bottles stand fast outside the door of the junkie priest in bed. Blood-stained white tiles lead to an imperfect escape to nowhere. Among the dying in the dust, the blind man hears nothing. All the time-worn bodies, their spirits long evaporated. Crawl for cover. No room here.
I'm the magic MC, not Matt So. I got the 411, so don't wait, let's go. She said, I see. I said, is that so? I see you in communique, not incommunicado. So pick up your pants and squinch up your dance. We're on our way to Lucis to spy your shadow. Here's Mixmaster Zen with the ricky-ticky tallywhack. Snap a line in your head and he'll pull out the rattle. Don't be frightened by the Ken, ask who, why, and when. Give your mama mad props and get ready for battle. We're beatific as the icons, with more beats than our fathers. We're spinning Gucci salads and we're tossing your daughters. Don't be frightened by the halos or the stars in alignment. They be lighting your path with the laser's refinement. We're mounting by the fountain on the shoulders of giants. We're aiming like crusaders with the sunset behind us. With Yahweh on our side and Hashem to ensure us, we'll settle for anointment and a honey most pliant. With a poem for a map and a butt with a crack, we're plumbing for the depths with the mighty Ken Wheeler. So don't let it linger. Take the berry with your finger, put it in your mouth, and say grazie to the healer. Now with the return to dash to your satchel and the bottle to its cap, show us to the door so the captain can retire. Now with the general in bed, let us get specific. We're on the royal road to Atene. It's going to be terrific. Not like the Hindenburg or even Dick Cheney. Our terror will be tourists, so here's your fair warning. In double-wide queues, pilgrims to the precipice. Vaccination vacation. Either way, they got no patience. Avoid their evil eyes, or they wants the damn selfie. Pay him no heed, nor the tall man's demanding. He's just passing on orders, but the bridge belongs to Amon. Only payment taken here is pennies for the bosun. Now you've got the right blinders, Master Zen his incantations. We'll be seeking analogues for to complement the ancients. With some mental gymnastics and poetic jurisdiction, we'll capsize the prose and dictator's intention. In the index of the Logos, where you'll find on the balance a table of contents and the spirits every mention. Put it in your grail, slurp up every sip. Everybody knows this, mendication's on the tip. Eucharist for agnostics and a cross for every doubter. You'll be crucified in jest like a sheep led to the laughter. If you think we're evangelic or mistake us for Christian, you ain't got a clue except this riddle's invitation. The story's not so simple like historical figures, unless you be meaning the geometry of number. And a universal mind inherent to water, incommensurate with one, divide by Zeus's daughter. He is the principle, she's the attribute. You take the good, you take the mad, you mind the thief as Zoe's loot. Then there you have it, pentagons of all knowing, the gold in the treasure, and your knickers are showing. There's a private in a box, and a Plato in a cave. Assange has the keys, and Hitler's all the rage. You square the spinning sun with the star of King David, you'll find gravity's rainbow right before the taking. The only alien is you, live on the evening news. And if you buy that, get a load of my shoes. They let me walk on oceans from here to Damascus. I'll deliver your bombs and collect all your taxes. So then there you have it. My information's true grit is softer in friction than a line in the sand. The journey's reward is yours for pursuing. But the target must be sought, or you'll find the stew bland.
Well, I have to preface it by saying that I've been with an intense Finnegan's Wake study group in Austin, Texas for now almost 2.5 years. And I've become more and more enamored of Joyce's writing and particularly the Finnegan's Wake. So in my dream, and I should say that I rarely remember my dreams and I rarely want to remember my dreams. But in this particular dream, I woke, I had this thing about the title Finnegan's Wake, which the Cognoscenti recognized there is no comma. There's no possessive in Finnegan's. And I decided in my dream that actually Joyce was referring to the people studying his book. He was telling everyone who is studying his book, To Wake. And if you know about Irish wakes, it's not all tears. It's drinking, it's dancing, it's celebrating life. So he's kind of using the imperative for the readers and the students of Finnegan's Wake. And he's also telling us that when we study Finnegan's Wake and enjoy Finnegan's Wake, that we are, that he is also Finnegan, the dead Finnegan, who when we discuss him and read him, we are waking him up and he can join into the party. So I kind of like that dream.
Thank you. COVID-19 vaccine. You're going to want to listen to this. The Red Cross says anyone who has received their COVID-19 vaccine cannot donate convalescent plasma to help other COVID-19 patients in hospitals. That plasma is made up of antibodies from people who have recovered from the virus, but the vaccine wipes out those antibodies.
Oh, we're not going to go past that. Like, you didn't just say what you just said. One more time.
But the vaccine wipes out those antibodies. He's making the convalescent plasma ineffective in treating other COVID-19 patients.
So you're telling me that the vaccine wipes out any natural antibodies that you had. If you have natural antibodies, they want you to take the COVID vaccine so that you no longer have antibodies. Effectively wiping out a treatment that could save people in the future that get COVID. To that point, convalescent plasma won't work. They don't fucking care about your health.
Blame it on a virus? Believe Pasteur? Ever hear of a man named Antoine Béchamp? The truth will shock you off your Roku. They always want to blame a little virus, like HIV and polio. Something so small they'll never find it, makes the perfect scapegoat. They always want to blame a little virus, never showing any proof. With something so small, no need to hide it, to cover up the real truth. They always want to blame a little virus, like HIV, Zika, polio, myelitis. The truth will shock you off your Roku. These microorganisms on which you blame your illnesses haven't actually been proven to exist. You never see the truth presented in the present. Your body makes its own viruses. When Pasteur's theory won over the public, Béchamp had the truth put down to be published. He learned the host terrain was everything. The germ on its own really did nothing. But Béchamp was ignored through history. Pasteur's plagiarized research became king. That's all I can say right now. The rest is gonna be censored. Beep.
Thank you. Thank you.